A 22-year-old techie fell victim to violence triggered by offensive posts on social media against Shivaji and Balasaheb Thackeray in Pune. The young boy was mercilessly beaten with lathis and iron rods because he belonged to the minority community, and it was a little-known fringe group, the Hindu Rashtra Sena, whose activists beat him to death. This is the anti-social face of social media that seems to be fanning communal violence. The question, though, is why are our political parties that are in power not doing anything to rein in the fringe?
Tension prevails in Pune after a 22-year-old techie was thrashed to death by an angry mob. Mohsin Sheikh, who belonged to the minority community, was attacked as part of the violence that raged across Maharashtra over derogatory Facebook posts related to Chhatrapati Shivaji and Shiv Sena founder Bal Thackeray. Mohsin and his friend were returning home after getting dinner when they were attacked, allegedly by people associated with the Hindu Rashtra Sena. Mohsin was beaten with lathis and iron rods because he was wearing a skull cap. The beating was so brutal that Mohsin didn't survive.
Police immediately spot pe pahunch gayi. Police ne kuch motorcycles wahan se baramad ki. Immediately kuch aaropiyon ko bhi arrest kiya aur ab tak 7 aaropi police custody mein hai. Ye sab aaropi Pune ke rehne wale hain. Prima facie, ye sab aaropi Hindu Rashtra Sena ke karyakarta hain.
Param pavitra Bhagwan Dhwaj.
Dhananjay Desai, the chief of Hindu Rashtra Sena, has denied that his outfit had anything to do with the techie's murder. But after Mohsin's death, situation in Pune is tense.
लोगों को ये बताने की हम लोग कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि काफी चीजें हैं अफवाहों की वजह से हो रही है. हमने ये रिक्वेस्ट किया लोगों को कि वो पुलिस से कांटेक्ट करें, पुलिस स्टेशन से कांटेक्ट करें, चौके उसको कांटेक्ट करें और क्या सही है क्या गलत है वो पहले जान तो ले.
Mohsin's death has once again highlighted the potential of how social media posts in India can be used to create communal mischief. Bureau report, headlines today.
Who'll rein in the fringe and who's responsible for the death of Mohsin Sadiq Sheikh, killed for no fault of his? Remember, he's not the one who went out and put up the allegedly derogatory posts. There was somebody else. But the mob was out on the hunt. They found whoever they thought was responsible and they beat him to death. The anti-social face of social media. Joining us on the program tonight, Tasleem Ahmad Rahmani, president of the Muslim Political Council of India. Rakesh Sinha works very closely with the Sangh Parivar as an ideologue for the RSS. Rahul Navrekar is representing the NCP Congress government in Maharashtra. I want to go across first to Tasleem Ahmad Rahmani. Who do you blame for what happened, sir, with Mohsin Sadiq Sheikh? Is this a one-off incident that could have happened in any place at any time? Or do you see this as being part of a larger conspiracy, sir?
See, I'll start with two things. Number one, I want to condemn the caricature or whatever the picture was put on the Facebook.
Yes.
Whosoever did it, I condemned it wholeheartedly. Now, and of course, Mohsin and other people, whosoever is affected, it should be condemned. Number two, it should be understood very clearly that this new government, this is a democratically elected, secular, socialist, democratic republic of India. Okay. Now, this is not the one incident. Since the government...
But what does this incident have to do with the new government?
This is the fifth incident in a row. You know, Bijapur, Ahmedabad, Baroda. All these places we have seen the communal clashes.
No, but you seem to forget it's the NCP Congress government that is in power in Maharashtra. How do you link this with the new government at the center run by Narendra Modi?
There is no difference between NCP Congress and BJP for this matter. Number two, there is a general atmosphere in the country. I have listened people saying now this is our government. Musalman thoda to dabke rahe na. So I want to tell that this is a secular and socialist government, whether it is the BJP government or the Congress government or the NCP government, whosoever comes to power.
Okay, I want to go across to Rakesh Sinha on this, because you're espousing the opinion that the new government somehow wants to pressure Muslims into keeping quiet, to subjugate them.
I don't know whether this is the government or the general feeling of the people.
Is it completely unfair, Rakesh Sinha, for Muslim organizations and for Muslim political leaders to link this to the Narendra Modi government at the center? Because we are hearing Tasleem Rehmani say that there have been 5 incidents since the new government came to power, and there are people therefore who believe that this could be part of a larger conspiracy. Mr. Rehmani, you've spoken. I want to now listen to Rakesh Sinha.
I am surprised to listen to him that the new government is responsible. Doesn't he know that it's the law and order is the state's, and there is the NCP government. I don't blame even the NCP. I blame the police mercenary, law and order mercenary, and the home minister of the state. If there is a derogatory poster, if there are rumors, the police should take steps. And he should arrest the anti-social elements. And moreover, the government is determined to implement the constitutional law. How you blame the Narendra Modi government? How you blame the BJP? How you blame the Sangh Parivar?
Answer that question, Mr. Rehmani.
Whatever the incidents happen, ex-union minister has been arrested.
They are sitting on the dormant rumors.
In Bijapur, ex-union minister belonging to Bharatiya Janata Party with 29 BJP workers named in the FIR, and one minister is arrested.
No, we're dealing with a specific case in Pune where you blame the new government, and I'm asking you, sir, what is the evidence to substantiate that charge? What we are seeing from the RSS is a very pragmatic response that if people are guilty, act against them. How can you link this to the Sangh Parivar and link this to the BJP and the
Rashtriya Hindu Sena and the Bajrang Dal and the Vishwa Hindu Parishad? There are so many frontal organizations belonging to
you are suggesting that the Rashtriya Hindu Sena, Rakesh Sinha, is a frontal organization for the RSS. Is that correct?
I am surprised that such a person, responsible person, is giving such irresponsible statement. RSS is a well-defined organization. Its organs are well-defined. Hindu Rashtra Dal has nothing to do with the RSS. And I am just telling you, even before the independence, such organization existed parallel to the Hindu RSS. And any miscreant elements, any hooligan elements can use the Hindu name, and I believe this is a
no, just because they have the name Hindu, Mr. Rehmani, in it, no, you can't claim that these people are RSS. How do you claim that?
There is no one organization. There are so many organizations.
No, but we're talking right now. No, once again, we're on specifics and we're talking about the Hindu Rashtra Sena, and you suggested at the beginning of the show that this is linked to the RSS. I'm asking you how.
Every time there is a new name. There are hundreds of such organizations which are using the Hindu name.
No, but surely you need to substantiate your charges, Dr. Rehmani. How can you level such broad-based allegations without having... Because what you're saying is the message that's going down in the minority community also. And there are people who are obviously lapping this up, but there is a very real concern that is there any direct linkage that you have evidence of which shows that the Hindu Rashtra Sena is linked to any body of the RSS? Rakesh Sinha is denying that.
If Rakesh Sinha is denying, they must condemn and they must arrest those people who are saying that we are Hindu Rashtra Sena. And number one, in Bijapur, the person who is arrested belonging, he is a ex-union minister belonging to BJP.
I want to go across.
And the FIR registered contains 29 BJP workers' name.
No, we're on the particular case that we're discussing. Isn't it the NCP government?
Vijay Rath.
One second. Just allow me to bring everyone in. Rahul Navrekar, is it not the NCP Congress government that must take the blame for what's happening in Pune? At the end of the day, to blame Narendra Modi for what's happening in Pune seems a bit far-fetched, given the fact that it's your government that could not protect Mohsin Sadiq Sheikh. He died for a post he didn't even put up. Forget whether it was derogatory, forget whether it offended people. He didn't even put it up. Random people, random mobs are going about finding people, lynching them to death. Why is your state government not protecting these people? Rahul Navrekar.
Well, Rahul, first and foremost, let me tell you, any killing, any taking away of life which is beyond the process of law has to be condemned irrespective of which government is in power. Number two, if you would be aware about the ground situation and realities prevailing in Maharashtra for the last 2 days after these most uncalled for, unwarranted and disgusting pictures were released on the social media, there has been absolute tension and stress in the entire state. Many of the districts have witnessed this stress. But the police in Maharashtra police as well as the Home Department has acted swiftly. And the entire situation is under control. Otherwise, this could have sparked off into a much larger tragedy, which has been controlled by the Maharashtra police. And the police have really done a good job, and they should be appreciated for this. Insofar as the innocent killing is concerned, absolutely unacceptable, and no one in their right mind would be able to justify this. The police has made arrest with regards to this. The police is investigating this matter on top priority. And let me assure you that in a short span from now, I am sure the police will be able to nab the culprits. Number three, religious, ethnic, cultural intolerance seems to have become a do-away factor in our society. We've seen it happening in the streets of Delhi, where students from Northeast were targeted. We've seen that happening in Maharashtra several times, where in District Thane, girls were harassed for making certain comments on
the
social
media. Who do you
blame for that? We've seen several such incidents. Whom do I blame for that? The people who are guilty of doing such things will be blamed for that. Insofar as the government is concerned, the government is leaving no stone unturned to get hold of the culprits, book them,
Dr.
and Rehmani, take them
are
to
you
task,
satisfied
and
with
set
the
an example in the state.
In Maharashtra, he's appreciating the police. Every time the police committed the wrong things, you know, the last time the Facebook, the two girls were arrested by very wrongly by the Maharashtra police, and then that occasion when the Azad Maidan has happened, those time also it was the lack of management and bandobast by the Maharashtra police. So this has become an order of the Maharashtra that there is no
Mr. Rehmani, you are not aware about the facts on ground. That's why you are making these statements.
Later, I want to say,
do you know
that
what has been happening in Maharashtra
game,
and the entire state for the last 2 days?
Whether this
if
is Congress or this is BJP, it is just killing the people. We have to come out with a solution.
That's where I want to go across to Bharat Kumar Raut. He's a senior journalist, has worked with the Shiv Sena, understands its functioning very, very closely. Mr. Raut, let us assume, and since those Facebook posts have now been taken down, I can't claim, and not many people can claim, to have seen the Facebook posts themselves. But let's assume something derogatory about Balasaheb Thackeray or Shivaji is put up over there. Why not just ignore those posts? Just let them be. There's some madman who's done it. Just let it be. Instead of coming out in the streets, protesting violently, mobs of the Hindu Rashtra Sena go attack Mohsin Sadiq Sheikh, who happens to be a Muslim but has nothing to do with that Facebook post. That innocent young boy is lynched to death. Why not just ignore these fringe on the other side? Why react so violently to them?
Now let me go point by point.
Yes,
first, your last point, that is about Hindu Rashtra Sena, whatever Sena you are talking about. This organization, at least I had not heard of so far. So it must be a new organization. I don't know its connections. I don't know from where it comes.
No, it is not a new organization. Dhananjay Desai, who runs this organization, has been arrested in connection with an earlier case. He's got 23 cases against him. This is not a new organization. These people have been around. They are repeat mischief mongers, sir.
Actually, this is the failure of the police.
Let me get in the details of that. What I am saying, if that organization has killed an innocent person, or even if he was guilty, but he has been killed out of the hands of the law, that has to be deplored, and it is for the police now to take action. If police cannot prevent, at least they should take post-fact action. Even that is not done. Now, after saying this, I am a champion. I am considered to be a champion of freedom of expression. On the floor of parliament, I have said time and again about any ban on any freedom expression. I have always opposed that.
Sir, I'm not talking but you're not answering my question. The Shiv Sena has sponsored protests where people are out on the streets protesting, vitiating the atmosphere.
But I'm asking
you, why not just ignore people who put up a crazy post? Why react violently to it is my question, Mr. Rao.
I think you are sitting on judgment without knowing the thing.
Yes.
Who told you that Shiv Sena has sponsored this? Who gave you the evidence that Shiv Sena sponsored it? If it is a spontaneous outcry, then how do you say that Shiva Sena is involved in it? All those who were protesting, do you think they belong to Shiva Sena? They did not belong to Shiva Sena, but definitely they are lovers of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj and Shiva Sena's late chief, Balasaheb Thackeray. So that is their expression. They express themselves. How do you blame Shiva Sena for that? Did Uddhav Thackeray give the call? Did any
sir,
of the
life
Shiva
is not as simple, not as black and white as that. These people didn't just come out in the streets to protest. Dr. Ramani, do you accept what Mr. Raut is saying? He says Uddhav Thackeray didn't action these protests. They happened spontaneously. Do you buy that, Dr.
No, it's not spontaneous at all. Nothing happens spontaneous in the country. That's what I want to make a point, that the police and the other intelligence forces, they know each and every step, each and every person, who are the mischief mongers and when they can be mischievous and when they can vitiate the peace of the community and the area.
No, but Mr.
Let me ask you this then. Do you condemn
these protests? Do you think the Shiv Sena tomorrow morning in Samna, when it puts out its editorial, should say, we don't approve of such protests? Tell these people, even if they're not Shiv Sena cadre as you claim, even if they're just sympathizers, should Uddhav Thackeray tomorrow morning in his signed editorial ask people to back off and just let the protests be for things in Maharashtra to calm down, Mr. Raut? Answer my question, sir.
Shiva Sena, if you must know, Uddhav Thackeray had made the appeal to the people to keep calm and quiet and abide by law and order. Why should they only give a call to Shiva Sena? If there some arrests have been done, the Home Department is under NCP, do you think that it would have spared Shiva Sena people? Has any leader of Shiva Sena, any deputy leader, even Shakha Pramukh of Shiva Sena, has been arrested for that? If it is not so, then why are you beating around the bush?
Okay, Mr. Rakesh Sinha, there are people who are saying that the Home Ministry should now consider banning the Hindu Rashtra Sena in the same manner in which Simi is banned. The Hindu Rashtra Sena too, Mr. Sinha, should be banned. Do you think that the RSS should support such a ban, or would you stand in favor of the Hindu Rashtra Sena?
Let me speak. You have already spoken. You are making a propaganda against the RSS. Let me remind you. In 2008, there were a series of attacks on the Christian organization and the churches, and the blame was on the Sangha Parivar. But the real culprit was the Dindar Anjuman, a Muslim organization. So there may be a larger conspiracy, what you are representing, that the Modi government, the RSS and Sangha Parivar is blaming. There is a NCP government. It is a law and order question of the state, and the state should take action. Hindu Rashtra Sena has nothing to do with RSS.
Will you go for the Communal Violence Protection Bill now in the House?
Mr. Sinha, let me try and paraphrase what you are suggesting. Hear me before you speak. Mr. Sinha, just listen to what I'm saying. So are you suggesting then that you have no problem if the Ministry of Home Affairs begins to assess whether the Hindu Rashtra Sena should be banned or not? Would you support such a ban, Mr. Sinha?
Look, these are the letterhead organizations. They don't have base. Nobody knows. And this gives the opportunity such people to blame that Hindu Rashtra Sena is linked with the Sangha Parivar. There are hundreds of the organizations. Kindly, RSS is a big organization. It has been founded in 1925. Kindly go and read. You are fighting with an organization which represents an alternative ideology.
Okay, Bharat Kumar Raut, I've heard from Rakesh Sinha. I want to hear from you as well. Would you support the NCP government?
It is mostly immoral,
okay.
Illegal.
We've heard you, Mr. Sinha. Bharat Kumar Raut, would you support the NCP Congress government in Maharashtra recommending a ban on the Hindu Rashtra Sena for these acts of violence? And this is not the first case. There are 23 cases at least against its founder, Dhananjay Desai. Mr. Raut.
Are you asking me the question?
Yes, Mr. Raut, I am.
Okay. Before answering this question, let me put a counter question to you and other panelists who have been talking about the ban on Hindu Rashtra Sena. We have nothing to do with whether you ban it or not. If this has this government or your channel or any other people have demanded banning MIM of Hyderabad, where its leader OSC had come in open had challenged the authority of the government.
That's not the question that I'm asking you, Mr. Rao. MIM made offensive speeches and action needs to be taken against them for that. But over here, the Hindu Rashtra Sena has blood on its hands. Mohsin Sadiq Sheikh has been killed. Why are you drawing an equivalence between the MIM and this? No, because you must answer my question, sir. Would you support a ban on the Hindu Rashtra Sena?
You are not allowing me to answer.
Okay,
you
go
are
ahead.
Not allowing me to answer.
Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, but I'm just making before this, Sambhaji Brigade is an organization which has been patronized by the NCP and NCP's leader, who was the Home Minister at that time and now also. Has anybody thought of banning Sambhaji Brigade for ransacking Bhandara?
But Mr. Raut, you are drawing a forced equivalence. Those questions are valid, and I accept that. But I'm asking you a direct question. In the wake of what has happened over the last 48 hours, does the Shiv Sena, in your opinion, have a problem if the Maharashtra government were to begin action against the Hindu Rashtra Sena? Answer just this question. Don't draw false equivalence.
I think whatever is due in law and execution of law, okay, that the government should take action. It is their duty. It is not for anybody to demand.
Okay, Rahul Navrekar, we are out of time on this program. We've heard from Rakesh Sinha and Bharat Kumar Raut. Both have no problem if action is taken against the Hindu Rashtra Sena. Surely a message needs to be sent out to the fringe.
And all such organizations.
Oh, absolutely. All such bodies, whether they are Hindu, Muslim or any other organization, no matter whose interest they claim to represent, if they act in this fashion, action should be taken against them. Would you recommend to your government in Maharashtra that they must immediately begin considering and assessing whether the Hindu Rashtra Sena should be banned, Rahul Navrekar?
Well, let me tell you one thing very clearly. It appears that Mr. Bharat Kumar Raut is in the habit of justifying one wrong with the other. But let me tell Mr. Raut, just for record sake,
that
the Maharashtra government
has banned. Don't deflect. Don't go off on a tangent. Rahul Navrekar, answer my question, sir.
I'll give you an answer to your question. Let me complete. Mr. Raut, for your information, Maharashtra government had banned Mr. Oasi from coming into the state of Maharashtra and delivering speeches against which he had raised a huge cry, which you are aware about.
Rahul Navrekar, I'm interested in listening to your response on the Hindu Rashtra Sena.
If it amounts to...
Rahul Navrekar, answer my question, please.
Let me complete and then you can speak. Yes, if it is required under law and if there is a threat to law and order situation by any organization, entity or individual, the state government shall take all the necessary action which is required.
Okay, everyone said the right things. Now we need to see those words translate into action. The fringe, no matter whether it is the MIM or the Hindu Rashtra Sena, whoever breaks the law, the full force of the law must come down on him. Yes. And I think the other larger message is, if that is being done, then surely we shouldn't find conspiracies where none exist. Yes. Especially in the context of what you're saying, Dr. Rehman, you surely can't blame the BJP government at the center. You've heard Rakesh Sinha condemn what happened. He's also saying ban the organization if they are found guilty.
You see the context of the killings. Since 26th May, there are five incidences and BJP people were arrested.
Not in this case, they were not. Do not spread false propaganda because the one thing that's happening and which is very disconcerting for me is on social media, all manner of propaganda is being spread.
It's
given
not,
how unchecked that
propaganda.
Is, people start believing this stuff, which is why we need to put the facts out, which is what we've attempted to do on the first part of Center Stage tonight. I want to end this broadcast over here. Rakesh Sinha, Rahul Navrekar, Bharat Kumar Raut and Dr. Rehmani for joining me on Center Stage tonight. Thank you very much. Mr. Raut, we are out of time. 10 seconds for you to make your final
point. One correction.
Yes. 10 seconds.
Yeah, I want to make one correction. Rahul said that MIM leader Oasi was banned from coming. I must remind him and through you all the viewers that the same MIM contested Nanded Municipal Corporation elections in Maharashtra.
I don't buy this forced equivalence. This is a forced debate. So you can't justify what the Hindu Rashtra Sena is saying with what the MIM did. If both are out of line, both need to be acted against. On that note, I end the first part of Center Stage. tonight, Dr. Rahmani, Rakesh Sinha, Rahul Navrekar, and Bharat Kumar Raut for joining me on Center Stage this evening. Thank you very much.